Hello and welcome to St. Nicholas. We are proud to take you on an educational journey around our school, the place where learning becomes an adventure. As you can see, our school is situated in the hills of Santana de Parnaíba, or around a 5-minute drive from the center of Alphaville. We are close enough to all the action of Alphaville, but far enough to enjoy peaceful and scenic surroundings. On weekends, this area is full of runners, cyclists and skateboarders, making the most of the environment and the view. Let's head inside. As an IB World School, we take pride in our mission statement and we take steps to ensure that it is prominently displayed upon entering the school so that all members of the community are aware of our values. We make the most of all the blank space our walls provide us with to display artwork, share student questions, and continue our learning outside the classroom. One of the first spaces you'll notice when you walk into the school is the library. The middle years library is at the entrance to the school and only a short walk from the middle school classrooms across the playground. It is our library, but also a centre for research and socialisation, as we aim to provide a welcoming and caring environment for students to collaborate, research and find pleasure in reading. Our primary library is located further down the corridor, only a few steps away from the playground, one of the many other places where adventures happen in school. And here we have the coordinator's office. This particular spot provides us with an excellent vantage point as we can look over the early years and primary playgrounds while also looking across at the middle years classrooms and the staff room. We are also close to the school office and the school nurse, so we are right in the thick of it during the hustle and bustle of the day. Our early years classrooms are designed for play with room for art, explorations and interactions. Inquiry is a central component of the learning process, and children ask questions and connect what they learn to their own lives. They are given tools and opportunities to gain independence and autonomy. Learning takes place both inside the classroom and in a range of green areas outside around the campus. Let's head over to the bridge that connects the early years to primary. The cross section are large open spaces where children, teachers and staff congregate, promoting a stronger sense of community. We have several different playgrounds that suit different age groups and different interests, and we are also able to use them for various sporting activities. The playgrounds encourage a sense of adventure. Without predictable toys, children find ways to use their imagination in a range of ways. Our bridge also leads us to the court, which is equipped for us to organize different sporting activities, including group and individual sports, martial arts, ball games, and athletics. We also have a football field by the middle years classrooms, which allows for both football as well as messier activities such as water play. Over here, we have a staff and resources room. It is situated halfway between primary and secondary and right across the hall from the lunchroom. It is easily accessible from all areas of the school and the calm island in the ocean of activity. Our new buildings, added only last year, include state-of-the-art facilities to support creative and performing arts as well as the sciences. Let's start by the auditorium. We have a fully equipped sound and lighting system, and facilities to support music and dramatic performances. This is also our assembly hall for presentations and graduations. Here we have the art and design room. This room is designed to let in as much natural light as possible, and it is equipped with the material and furniture necessary to support group and individual projects related to digital design, as well as other hands-on projects and artistic ventures. And now we are entering the science lab. This lab was inaugurated in August 2019, and it is designed to support the three sciences, physics, biology, and chemistry, while adhering to strict safety guidelines. And this is Frank. Next door, we have the music room. This room is conveniently located close to many smaller practice rooms, but also close to our ICT resource room, so that students can study music in both electronic and more physical forms. We have a range of instruments at our disposal, and we make full use of musical software and applications to produce and understand music. All of our classrooms are connected through two corridors, one covered and the other that connects the art and science rooms to the sports facilities. Our lunchrooms for the older students are located in the center of the school, and this is where our staff and teachers gravitate to around lunchtime. We offer a range of vegetarian, vegan and meat options every day, together with dessert and snack as part of a balanced diet. For those that crave that little bit extra, we also have our tuck shop that offers nutritious yet refreshing snacks. And here we have the primary classrooms. As you can see here as well, the boundary between the indoors and the outdoors is blurred, as we do not limit our learning to the classrooms, especially not in such beautiful surroundings on a sunny and warm day. Students continue to inquire and make meaning from authentic experiences. Students learn to collaborate and co-construct a unit of learning together with their teachers. They have access to technology and other learning tools that help them develop skills. Let's take a look inside the middle years classrooms. Each classroom is shared between several teachers, which facilitates collaboration and the connection between subjects. Our furniture is designed to support an easy transition between individual and collaborative work, and we make as much use of outdoor spaces as possible. As a growing school, we look toward the future and have already begun laying the groundwork for buildings that will support the learning of our students in the future. Here we have the foundations for a new building that will have specialized science labs, media center, and classrooms that are built to support independent and collaborative learning that give students the freedom to choose where and how they learn. On behalf of the St. Nicholas community, I hope to see you join us on an educational adventure.